What are you doing the rest of your life? North and south and east and west of your life. I have only one request of your life. That you spend it all with me. Those tomorrows waiting deep in your eyes, and walls of love you keep.
I'm Richard Blackwell, and welcome to Jazz on My Mind. Today we're in beautiful Leimert Park Village, and I've got a gorgeous young lady with me today. Not only is she a beautiful woman, but she's a fabulous jazz singer with a lot of history. And I'm talking about the one and only Sarah Baldwin. Sarah, welcome to Jazz on My Mind.
Thank you, Richard.
It's a pleasure to have you here with us today, Sarah. And you know, Sarah, I met you, and you were with my other brother in jazz, Mr. Chester Whitmore. And Chester told me that's a lady that you got to get on the website. So here you are, and I'm happy that you're with us today. Now, Sarah, I know, I spoke to a few other people. You have sang with a lot of people in the jazz world and also the old doo-wop world. Give the audience, the Jazz on My Mind audience, some of the names of the people that you have the pleasure of singing with. Mm-hmm.
Well, Benny Carter is my original mentor, and then Eddie
Bill. Okay.
Eddie Bill was my vocal coach, but he was a vocal coach of the Stars.
Okay.
And Jimmy Smith.
The great organist, Jimmy Smith.
Yeah. Herb Jeffrey.
Yeah.
Bruce Brown. Sarah Vaughn and I got a chance to do some stuff together. Vi Red. I worked with John Handy and Freddie Hubbard.
Now, John Handy had a big song out called Hard Work.
Absolutely.
And you also had a pleasure to work. What was the other name you said after John?
Freddie Hubbard.
Freddie Hubbard, who passed away.
And Stanley Turrentine.
That's my wonderful, wonderful saxophonist.
And Jug Emmons. I worked with Freddie, Stanley, and Jug at the York Club of Florence and Western.
That was, wow.
Yeah.
I know, that was, to be able to work with Stanley Turrentine and Freddie Hubbard at the York Club.
And Jug Emmons.
Oh my goodness.
Jug was the man.
Now, you started singing, what age did you start singing?
Two.
Who was some of your inspiration and some of the people that you admired as you were growing up? Who were some of the singers that you liked to listen to?
Well, my mom was the best singer ever.
Wow.
So that's my mentor. My original mentor is my mother. She was a singer.
Mm-hmm.
And she was the first president of the NAACP in Natchez, Mississippi in 1947.
And your mother's name was?
Frances Baldwin. She passed away a couple of years ago. She was 89 years old.
What a life.
Oh, she had a great life.
What a life.
She taught a lot of people to read and write. She was just fabulous.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but she made sure that my mother was an educator, so she just believed in getting the movement part of
right.
everything.
Which is reading?
All of it.
She
started me taking voice lessons when I was 10,
mm-hmm.
you know. And then I went on from there to Fine English, which I graduated from.
Mm-hmm.
Then I went to Tupelo College. All the music, all the voice.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's beautiful.
Yeah.
So as you were aspiring to be a singer, who did you listen to as you were?
Everybody. We had a cafe. And that's we lived on Canal Street, which faced the Mississippi Bridge. And at the bottom of the hill,
I'm from
Natchez. So there, at the bottom of the hill, we had a cafe, which we had a jukebox then.
Mm-hmm.
So everybody was on. So I knew every song on the jukebox. And my mom was doing hair and teaching, and she sang all day long, so I was always surrounded by music.
Isn't that beautiful?
Yeah, my sister and I, we just knew every song that was out.
Wow. Mm-hmm. Wow. Now, your first professional job, who did you sing with professionally when you first started?
Sir Neville Godfrey.
Okay.
So then Dr. Neville was one of my vocal coaches. I had a lot of vocal coaches. Then he was one.
Okay.
Sir Neville Gottfried, Carl Jones was another, Bob LeBeau, and Florence Russell. Mm. Once I said opera was with Florence Russell. No. My first professional job, they just started there and they expanded. Like when I got with Eddie Gill.
Mm-hmm. And that was your vocal coach.
Yeah. But Benny Carter was first. I was with Benny first, and he hooked me up with Eddie Bill at a show, a Williams recording over in Hollywood.
Oh my goodness, Joe Williams.
Yeah,
that's you're talking about baritone super singing.
Yeah, so Benny was going to record me, and some things personally changed for him. So he said, I have the man I really want you to, you know, and then he had us to meet down there, and it started and lasted until Eddie died. It was over 15 years.
That's beautiful.
So we created Vine Street Bar and Grill with entertainment, mm-hmm. and we did the hiring in there, and we worked at Lake of Fame, we worked Palm Springs, we worked wherever they were paying, we were working. With what we would do also, Buddy Collette.
Okay.
Buddy would be working on a job, in and out, we'd be like on our break.
Yeah.
So we'd take the break and we'd go to the other gig.
Right.
And he'd be walking and do it, he'd walk down, and I'd get on the pill, I'd get on the microphone, he'd walk out with another job. So what I appreciate about the guys, they were very astute, professional mm-hmm. musicians.
Yes.
They were all gentlemen.
Yes.
They always protected me.
You see, with that, you can't go wrong with a company like that. You know, you're talking about it being in the company of Joe Williams, John Hammond, Freddie Hubbard. I mean, come on. Those are guys, those are legends.
I work with John a lot, too. John, yes, he's wonderful. He's a marvelous person. Mm-hmm. He's wonderful to work with, too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Now, are you still singing at this point?
Absolutely.
Now, you've got a lot of songs, because not only are you a vocalist, you're also a songwriter.
Yeah.
How many songs do you think you've written in your career?
I started writing when I was 14.
Okay.
Yeah, so a lot. Mm-hmm. I have a lot of songs.
So are you still singing at this point now?
Right now I'm doing a play, one, with the Urban Arts Theater West.
Okay.
I've been with Steve Simeon, who is our director, choreographer, writer. I've been with him over 15 years.
What are you doing in the play? What is the play called? Is there a title?
One.
It's called One.
It's called One.
Okay.
Starring Daryl Coley.
Mm-hmm.
And we're going to be doing something in a few days.
That's beautiful.
Showcase. A Backers audition, that's what it is. We're going to be doing a Backers audition.
Okay.
But you should, oh my God.
I'm going to make a point to come and see that.
You have to.
And now it's going to be at the Urban Arts Theater. Where is it located?
That's the title. That's the name of our theater group.
Right.
The music that's done in here is by Byron Smith. He and Steve Simeon. Steve writes the lyrics and Byron does the music.
Now, if someone like Jazz My Mind listeners or viewers want to come and see you perform in this play?
Well, it's going to be not in this information that I have, but I do have it. Maybe we could post it on the website sometime.
We could post it on the website, and not only that, I'm going to give our Jazz and my mind viewers a little insight that Sarah Baldwin is going to be with us throughout the upcoming months on Jazz on My Mind. So please make sure that you stay tuned, because not only will she have that information, but you'll get a chance to learn more about Sarah Baldwin. Now, you're in a play. Are you still writing songs now?
I'm still writing. I'm writing some stuff right now that's so good.
Ladies and gentlemen, my guest today has been the beautiful, talented vocalist, Miss Sarah Baldwin. I'm Richard Blackwell, and once again, thank you for watching Jazz on My Mind.
On a king. Oh, let me be the one to hear that silent wish you make, those tomorrows waiting deep in your eyes, and a world of love you keep in your eyes. I'll awaken what's asleep in your eyes. It may take a kiss of two, or three, or four, or more.